in just what you said, that our collections favor science and technology and do not favor the liberal arts. That's not something I can prove, and my colleagues have told me repeatedly there's no way I can prove this theory. But I still think it may be a valid theory that at Purdue, we are buying heavily in the science technology book fields. And so when the user goes to the shelf, they find the book that they want on the shelf or in the online catalog. When the liberal arts person or someone wanting a liberal arts book goes to the shelf, we're buying a smaller percentage of those books, so the chance of the book you wanting being on the shelf is less. So what do? You ask for it on interlibrary loan, and then we buy it. So I think that that's true, but I can't prove that. However, Texas A&M saw the same pattern. There's a report in our issue on Texas A&M, and they are a SciTech university also. They saw the same pattern, and their response was, well, that's what we expected. We saw the same pattern, and we said, we didn't expect this. Why is this happening? I don't know why they expected it. They didn't answer that question. But it does seem to be not just Purdue. It seems to be quite universal that people are reading books in the liberal arts and maybe not reading as many books in the sciences.
Thank you, Judith. Bien, tratando.
Short question.
Gary, I'm sorry.
Una breve pregunta. Helen, Judith, what about the question of the amount of information in the sciences, mathematics, that's published serially rather than in books? My guess would be that much more information in the sciences, et cetera, is published in serial format rather than in book format, and that that has something to do with the parameters.
Yes, we know that the sciences are very periodical or very journal dependent, and that's where their research is published. So that's certainly something that's certainly true. However, the great gap that we saw in the difference is, I don't think, can really be explained simply by that. I mean, that was the first answer that everybody said. Well, of course, we know they're journal dependent. We know that they read journals, and that's true, but not such a gap as we see. So yeah, I do think that's a force at hand, so certainly that needs to be considered. Social science people are pretty journal dependent too when we look at the usage. I think liberal arts are I think humanities are a little more book oriented, but we see this pattern very strongly in a lot of the social sciences also.
Gracias. Quiero pedirles, por favor, que nos concedan 5 minutos para escuchar la pregunta de Abel. Permíteme tantito, sí. 5 minutos, colegas, y terminamos la mesa.
It is not a question, it is a study we did with 230 Brazilian journals, citing, looking what they cite during 3 years. And the relationship is exactly what you said, 85% of citation in biomedical, biological are to journals, and 15 to books. And when you go to humanities in general, the trend is the contrary.
Okay, so what you're saying is in your study that in the science and the medical fields, they are relying 85% on the journal literature and only 15% on the book literature. So yeah, that is an interesting parallel.
Bien, tratando de formular algunas conclusiones después de escuchar la participación de nuestros ponentes, pudiéramos decir tal vez que los criterios que deben prevalecer para el diseño, la planeación y la construcción de acervos y colecciones en la biblioteca del futuro son muy diversos. Tienen que ver con identificar y satisfacer las necesidades de los usuarios. Tienen que ver, por supuesto, con la disponibilidad económica. Tienen que ver con las características físicas de la biblioteca y, como Pascal lo mencionó, también con la preparación del personal involucrado en la prestación de los servicios de información después de que se integran estos acervos. En todo caso, como hemos escuchado desde el día de ayer Y hoy nuevamente en la conferencia de CHIP, el futuro pudiéramos imaginarlo, pero no sabremos cómo se presentará hasta no estar en él. En todo caso, que tengamos vida ustedes y nosotros para presenciar esos nuevos retos y tratar de atenderlos adecuadamente. Que tengan muy buenas tardes.